What's up, guys? My name is Brandon, and today Apple released iOS 15.4.1 a little under 3 weeks after the big release of iOS 15.4. And along with this release, we also got iPadOS 15.4.1, tvOS 15.4.1, HomePodOS 15.4.1, watchOS 8.5.1, and macOS Monterey 12.3.1. But of course, in this video, we're talking all about iOS and iPadOS 15.4.1, and this update is one that should fix a lot of issues that you guys have been facing with 15.4. So we're going to talk about those fixes, along with the performance, the battery life, and if you should update or not. We'll also briefly touch on some of those macOS issues that have been patched as well. And as always, if I notified you of this update before your iPhone did, make sure to hit that subscribe button down below. All right, so let's first take a look at the size of this update. So you can see here, iOS 15.4.1 came in at 313 megabytes on my iPhone 13 Pro. That size will vary depending on your device and the version you're coming from, but it should not be a very large download. It should be under 500 megabytes for most people. So let's go and check out the build number for this update in our settings, general, about. We can see here the new build number is 19E258. And if we scroll down to the modem firmware, you can see that is 1.59.03. So no change from 15.4. All right, so now what's new here in 15.4.1? And as always, with a double point update like a 0.4.1, we're not expecting any big new features or changes. We're expecting mainly bug fixes. And that's exactly what this update brings. So battery drain was easily the biggest issue for most people after updating to 15.4. And I even discussed that in depth in my latest Apple Weekly episode last Saturday. But thankfully, this update fixes that issue. So if you look at the release notes here, you can see Apple mentions a fix for, quote, battery may drain more quickly than expected after updating to iOS 15.4. So it's pretty rare for Apple to actually name drop battery drain in the release notes. They don't do that too often. So it's good to see that they actually did notice an issue with battery draining and addressed a fix for that here with 15.4.1, less than a month after the release of 15.4. This update also includes a fix for made for iPhone hearing devices like hearing aids. Those may have lost connection within some third-party applications on 15.4, but this update fixes that. So if you're having issues with your made for iPhone hearing device, specifically in third-party applications, that issue should be addressed in 15.4.1. And then the final thing mentioned in the release notes is a fix for Braille devices. So Apple says, quote, Braille devices may become unresponsive while navigating text or displaying an alert. So three main fixes with this update, but of course, Apple does also include other bug fix updates that they don't mention in the release notes. So I would expect to see other bug fixes, and we'll talk more about those this weekend in my follow-up video, because I'm sure other bugs have been squashed with this update as well. They just were not mentioned. So Apple did also release watchOS 8.5.1 today. So that did include bug fixes. I know some people had issues with battery draining and some Series 7 watches would not charge properly. So I would assume that watchOS 8.5.1 fixes those issues. And then more importantly, macOS also got an update with 12.3.1, and macOS 12.3 had a ton of bugs, a lot of really bad bugs like bricking Macs and things like that as well. But you can see here, Apple did mention a couple of fixes for macOS Monterey 12.3.1. USB-C or Thunderbolt external displays do not turn on when connected to a Mac Mini 2018 as a second display. There's also a fix for game controllers. So you can see Apple mentions Bluetooth devices such as game controllers may disconnect from your Mac after playing audio through some Beats headphones. And then Apple didn't mention it in the release notes, but I would assume that 12.3.1 fixed the issue where version 12.3 would brick Macs with a replaced logic board. So if you replaced your logic board in your Mac and you tried to update to macOS 12.3, it would just brick your device. So I would assume that that doesn't happen with 12.3.1. But anyways, going back to iOS 15.4.1, did you guys have any other issues with 15.4 after updating? Because I feel like the storage bug, a lot of people don't really have that bug anymore when you go into your iPhone storage and it just would not calculate up there. You may need to wait like 5 to 10 minutes for older devices for that to properly calculate up here, your storage. But I mean, aside from the storage bug and the battery drain bug, I don't really see any other issues with 15.4. I'm sure there are others, but let me know in a comment down below if this update fixed them and exactly what that bug was. I will also mention that in my Apple Weekly episode this coming Saturday. And then as far as security updates in 15.4.1, you can see here we do have one CVE that has been addressed. So it's an Apple AVD bug. And it says here the impact was that an application may be able to execute arbitrary code with kernel privileges. And Apple is aware of a report that this issue may have been actively exploited. So that is definitely something you want to be aware of. Anytime that an issue has been actively exploited, that's something you definitely want to take note of and update your phone for. So you can see here the description was an out-of-bounds write issue was addressed with improved bounds checking. And then moving on to the performance, I would not expect any boost to performance from 15.4 to 15.4.1, mainly because this is just a bug fix update. Apple is only focusing on the bugs. So unless there was a bug that impacted the performance, you know, of 15.4, I would not expect any type of improvement to the performance here on 15.4.1. But nonetheless, I will show you guys the Geekbench scores on a 13 Pro. So we got a 1732 on the single core and a 4748 on the multi-core. So pretty respectable scores, but again, you're not really going to notice a big change from 15.4. Now, as far as battery life goes, of course, battery life, you are going to see an improvement with 15.4.1 because that was one of the bugs that Apple patched with this update is the battery drain. So if you did face any type of battery drain, or you just noticed that you weren't getting as much on-screen time as you were on previous versions of iOS, you should expect to see a fix for your battery. Your battery should last longer and like it did pre-iOS 15.4. All right, so now should you update to iOS 15.4.1? And I say, if you updated to 15.4, then absolutely, it's a no-brainer to update to 15.4.1. This is the supplemental bug fix update to fix any issues that may have been caused by updating to 15.4. And even if you didn't update to 15.4 because you were scared of all the battery drain reports, now is probably a better time to go ahead and consider upgrading because the battery drain has been resolved with this 15.4.1 update. Not to mention this bug that may have been actively exploited also gets patched with 15.4.1. And then finally, let's talk about what to expect next from Apple in terms of software updates. So next up is going to be an iOS 15.5 beta 1. So if you are on the beta program, if you get betas on your phone, you should be seeing a 15.5 beta 1 within the next few weeks. So it's hard to say with Apple, they've gone a really long time, probably a record long time without releasing a beta, but we are expecting to see 15.5, the final release, sometime around early June, end of May, early June, according to Mark Gurman. So that's what we're going to see next in terms of a big public release, but we should also see a 15.4.2 and maybe even a 15.4.3 before we see a 15.5 final release. But nonetheless, we should see a beta for 15.5 go out pretty soon, and I would also expect a 15.4.2 sometime in April as well. But anyways, guys, there you have it. That is iOS 15.4.1, a very small update, but a very important one, especially if you were having battery drain issues on 15.4. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, as always, I would appreciate if you give it a thumbs up, and of course, make sure to subscribe for a lot more iOS update videos and my Apple Weekly video this coming Saturday, where I'll discuss just how much better the battery life is on 15.4.1. But anyways, guys, thanks again for watching, and I'll see you soon.